News Talk 810. I'm Michael Finney. This is Consumer Talk. And joining me on the live line is Andrew Eisner. Hey, Andrew, thanks for joining us.
Glad to be here.
What's the name of your website?
Retrievo.com. That's R-E-T-R-E-V-O.
We're having you on because you had an interesting take on daylight saving time.
That's correct.
There's more to deal with than I gave it thought to, isn't there?
Well, you know, you take that blinking 12 problem that we used to see years ago and multiply that a few times, and now everybody's got a house full of gadgets that all have the equivalent of blinking 12s on them now, and the problem is that many people have either thrown away their manuals or put them someplace where they can't find them. And what do you do when you don't have the manual and you can't figure out how to set the time?
What do you do?
Funny you should ask. Actually, Retrievo has been collecting manuals for a number of years, and we've got over 100,000 manuals for, you know, gadgets and gear. And you can go to retrievo.com, and in many cases, you can even put in the model number, the make, and then in many cases, you can put in a phrase like set time or set clock, and Retrievo will bring up the exact page. Now, it won't do that for every product because we don't have the manuals for every product, but we do have an awful lot of them.
What cracks me up is in your list that got sent to me was your camera. And you're right. All of my cameras are never correct. The little date stamp that you have on there.
Sure. I mean, you know, these days it's cameras, camcorders, you know, microwave, coffee makers, fax machines, TVs. I mean, everything's got a clock in it. And you're right. If you've got the wrong time stamp on your camera, it's not a good situation.
Well, you know, and the thing is, I really don't need to know what time it is right when I'm making a pot of coffee.
Well, you know, that's true, except some people do rely on that coffee being made when they get up in the morning.
Oh, that's true. That's true. No, mine's got the automatic thing.
Uh-huh.
That's a crack up. How long does it take you to go through your house? I'm just curious, Andrew.
You know, my problem is I try to catch everything on one sweep, you know, so a Sunday morning I'll sweep through my gadgets and probably take me a good 20, 30 minutes, but, you know, there's always something. You know, you get in the car, and there's your car radio that's blinking the wrong time.
Not true anymore, but, you know, I can tell you that I've had cars that I could not figure out how to do it. So it was just like, well, it's just going to be an hour off 6 months out of the year.
Yeah, I mean, you know, and here's the other problem is that, you know, they changed the day in 2007 from the first Sunday. Remember, it used to be in April. It used to be the first Sunday in April, and then they changed it to the second Sunday in March. So what happened is that there are a lot of old products that were programmed to change the time on the first Sunday in April. Now, if those old products haven't had their firmware upgrade, which they probably haven't, there's a chance that something, if you've got an older product that's got automatic, you know, daylight saving time correction, it may change on the wrong day. So you'll be stuck changing this thing four times a year.
That's a crack up. Andrew Eisner, Retrievo.com, R-E-T-R-E-V-O.com. If you don't know how to reset your clock, go there and you can get it done. Andrew, thanks a lot for joining us.
Anytime.
I'm Michael Finney. This is Consumer Talk on KGO.